Hello everyone, and welcome back to another tutorial series on Transport Fever 2. Today I want to have a look at personal transport and emissions. As I mentioned last episode, we want to establish a personal transport line from one to another city, and I want to do some track optimization and expanding of already existing tracks, and I want to explain some secrets about emissions and how you handle this. So let's jump right into it and let's have a look at our current system. We have right now two cities which are connected with different cargo routes. In this case it's Wildenburg, which we have over here. We get some deliveries from Tool Factory to the east, and we get some construction material from the west side here, and we have different lines already which are in a profitable state. You can see on the balance overview in the line statistics, and I also edited some express lanes through the station, as you can see here. And there's one thing I didn't notice last game but I want to correct, which is the station extension radius. As you can see here, if I highlight the station with my mouse cursor, there's these two tracks highlighted and there are these two tracks highlighted. That's because I accidentally edited this station and extended it way further than it should be. So let's pause the game here, and now I delete these parts. So the station isn't extended over the outer parts, it should be, and the station wide is like 240 meters. This is the second most possible length you can do by default. And of course now I have to rebuild some of these tracks. Let's do this real quick so the lines can operate normal again, like so. And also, you can't place signals on top of station extensions. That's why I want to correct this. And you also can't do some crossings, which I want to do here on this side. Okay. Now, these two signals I want to place in front of station itself. There are our two waypoints. And also I noticed a lot of YouTubers and gamers tend to use way more signals than they should. Another thing you should know about signals is they cost maintenance. So if we have a look from time to time, there will pop up like $22 from every signal in the game right now, which is a lot. I've placed like 100 signals. So let's run this and let's see if the tracks are properly set. Yeah, we have our tool line over here on this track, our concrete material here, and our two express lanes in the middle. And I also switched out on this side that our quarry line comes in on the right track and station, and our construction material on the left track, so they don't interfere with each other. Okay. Now for the part we want to do today. I want to establish a personal transport route. And let me have a look here. Oh, this is okay. And we will go from Wildenburg to Marl, which is down here. Why would I do this? Because Marl also needs construction materials and tools, which we already fabricate. So both goods can be delivered too, and we can expand our production line even further. We have another forest over here to feed this sawmill, and we can also increase our tool factory by two more levels, so we can afford to deliver to another city. So how do we do this? Before we start with establishing personal transport, as you can see here, $22 per sign, I want to talk about emissions. Emissions were added to Transport Fever 2 and they weren't in the game before Transport Fever 1. If you open up your overlay on the menu left, you can see what emissions are. Normal status is like average, and these red fields only show emissions like sound, noise and also pollution. And if you switch from average to current, you can really nice see how these trains have like a voice or noise barrier carrying with them, and these noises extend outwards, so the affected buildings are only residential areas, which are highlighted here. On the other hand, you can see all commercial and industrial buildings are not affected at all. That means you should place your cargo stations or railroad stations on this side of the town where no pollution is affecting anything. In this case, my station over here is pretty bad place because it all the time a train passes by, it's affected by the noise, as you can see here coming in. And if I move my cursor, mouse cursor over the building, you can see here this number is increasing. See, it's raising, and this is a bad thing because if you have a look at the station window, the city window, you can see it's poor condition for noise and emissions. So I get a minus of possible 38 residents, which are not in the city right now because of all the noise. So next town we build a station, we will take care of this. There are some mods on the workshop which reduce noise with sound barriers, but right now I only will take care of this in the next city. This one will be affected by noise, but I don't care really. Okay, this is emissions. Also, your trucks and lorries do emit some pollutions and emissions. As you can see here, this little road vehicle emits, if you go to the details tab, 75 emissions. And mediocre condition means it has plus 2. Why does this plus 2 come from? This plus 2 comes from the wearing out of the vehicle, which is negated by the maintenance cost. So you can maintain your vehicles and you won't get these plus emissions. This basically means if you have your vehicle set to high maintenance costs, like here, you would never get any plus on your emission side. But if you leave it like normal and the running costs are like zero, then they get additional emissions. And this is what this game is about. If you pay higher costs, your emission is stable. But if you won't, your emission will rise over time. And this is how you manage your emissions by using vehicles with low emissions. There are some street buses, gas driven buses and so on. Which you can use in your city, and also not only the use of the vehicles but also the setting of the line of the vehicles. As you can see, if I open up my line window, I have this construction material here in the city. Let me pin this so we can see the track. And oh, this was the wrong one, sorry, truck route I mean, this one. And if I open up my emissions, you can see how this line is affecting all the emissions in the city. See, there's a little truck and there's the emission following, and it's right, it's going right through the residential area, which is really really bad. So what would be better, we have our cargo pickup point over here and our commercial zone or industrial zone where we deliver our stuff. So it would be way better to let these lorries drive on here where they don't affect residential area, and over this way. It's a little bit longer and it's not the direct straight line, but would be better for emissions. So let's correct this by setting some waypoints. So we go to the street tool, waypoint, and we place one waypoint over here going north and one here going south. And now we add these waypoints into our line tool. So let's manage this line. Right after the pickup point, Lower Wildenberg, we set at station for this northern point. And after the Albert Road, which is the last point in this route, we set this point. Now you can see they're going a longer way, which you can compensate by adding more vehicles on this line. But the emission in this part of the city should become significantly lower. So let's have a look on our emissions. Yeah, let's run this for a little while. You see, this lorry is going this way this time. Oh, by the way, I should switch out these two because it's running a circle right now. So let's do this. So let's do 4, 5 and then 3. So let's delete Mill Road. And then add Mill Road after Albert. It's going a simple circle. Okay. Okay, emission window. As you can see, this part is now slightly less affected by emissions. And this should increase our quality in the city. Just a small tweaking, but in long term should affect the city. And we could we could make it even better if we place a road down here. Let's try this. Close this one. We have to delete some buildings over here, which is okay for me. And then we place another pair of waypoints over here. Let's see if these are already affecting the line. No, they aren't. So let's manage this again. So let's go for this one first. And then on this one later. Okay, now we have another issue here because I placed one-way entrances over here. So we will switch out these both. So let's pause the game. Let's configure this one and delete this. No, not this one. Just this one. And let's delete this one. I can't. Okay, let's see. Yeah, let's do this over here and delete this one. Okay, now let's have a look at the line. Okay, now it's almost perfect. So we go around the residential area and our pollution should be better. Okay, this is how you manage and control your emissions in the residential area, and we will have a look at this in other cities too. And keep in mind, if you place your initial station at a city, try to avoid setting it next to residentials. Speaking of this, we want to establish another station at mall, so let's see where we can go to. For this, we open our high layer. And we go right to the middle of the track, and then we can see mall or in distance over here. So the least height differences we have in a straight line down here, I guess. And then let's have a look at the areas. We have residential over here, we have commercial here and industrial here, which means we should add our station away from the residential way over here. So let's do this, and let's build a station over here. In this case, I want personal transport. So let's build passenger station with 240 meters and two lanes already. And also, one second, let's turn it back this way. And I also, let's pause the game. And I did this this road because we want it a little bit more outwards, straight line here. And let's delete this one. We will take care of this later. First of all, we want to place a station here. Like so. And of course, we also want to deliver some goods, so we modify the station for cargo terminals. And I guess two are plenty, so we will add two more tracks on this side for cargo deliveries. Keep in mind to leave one end of the station open, just for later if you have longer trains, like 200 to 300 meters. Right now, this is fine. Add one cargo platform. So we have 1, 2, 3 passenger lines and one. And let's add another track on this side, two possible cargo lines. How we connect these, I will show you later. Okay, what do we need also is a possibility for passengers to reach the terminal. So we have to place some passenger buildings over here so they connect to the road. Let's do this here. And also we need some cargo buildings for the trucks and lorries. So let's place one here. And also we need street connection with truck depots. So let's go over to the building site for tram station. I would like to place it right next to the entrance and connect it to the street, like so. Also keep in mind, if you place a tram station or something, it's extending north. I'll show you what I mean. If you modify the station later on, you can only extend upwards with your passenger, like so. It's extending in this direction. Keep that in mind if you place it. Then let's place the truck depots. And we could place these on the outer end also. Yeah, like so. And we connect the street. And we extend this also by one square on each side, or two maybe. So there's plenty room for cargo to be placed on. And of course, now we also need some depots for public transport and a road depot for trucks. Tram station. Okay, this is all we need for the beginning. And as you can see, you have now personnel and cargo transport at this station. So we are good to go on this city. Only thing we need to establish are lines and vehicles. But first, we need to build our tracks. We are right now at 1900 and I stopped it here because I let the game run for a couple of years. As you can see, I accumulated like 134 millions for building, which is only the output of the basic lines. There's nothing else going on. I paid all debt here, so enough money to establish our economy. And keep in mind, if you establish your first passenger transport, it doesn't doesn't go well in the beginning because your personal transport needs to be established over a while. That means if you establish a public route inside a town, it takes a while until passengers will come to the station. So don't expect to have profit from the beginning, like it's on the cargo side transport. Yeah, it takes time. Okay, for the track laying, I go here and let's close this one. And now you see I have 5 lanes which I need to connect. So first of all, I go straight out with the maximum speed possible, like 120 right now. And parallel to this, I go the second track. And these two outer lines are the cargo lanes. So I will join these two into one, like so. This is too far. I need to extend even further because I wanted to have more speed until it reaches the station. So I will extend this even further. And now we go into this station. Yeah, this is fine. Delete this part. Okay. So it can join up later. Okay, how do we connect these two? There are two ways. One example would be to go for both inner and join the outer into the inner tracks, or you join one side of the track into another, and this is what I will do. Let me see, I need to go straight line over here. So I keep it straight, and then I join in these two at maximum speed of 120 kilometers per hour. And if you take this snap point right over here from the end of the switch, it's absolutely symmetrical and perfect. So now trains can choose which station they go to. In this case, all cargo trains would go the right lane because this will join in here, like so. And also it will come back if it's driving out of the station and going this way. We will have another switch over to the right track. So I snap it over here. The opposite side of this one, which will go this way then. Nope, won't. Too far outside, so let's go over here, like so. And then the trains can go back from here, to this side. Okay, now for the crossings in front of the station, which I already do by default. Something strange is going on here, so let's delete this one and try the other side first. This is weird. Here we go. Okay, now for the signal placement. On this track, keep in mind, it must be two-way, so let's place both, and in front of this switch we will have a stop here, because if it's going the other way around, it's going on this lane, which is fine. So we will put this signal on this track into this direction. And on these, we will have switches over signals over here. this way is fine. Yeah, this way, and this way, and this way. Now in front of these switches, and this should be it for this section. You could place another one on here, if you're waiting. And if you are, if you have problems to measure your distance between the signals, later on you should go for like 300 meter distances. You can simply pick a station and put it to 300, and if you rotate it, you can see this should be the approximate signal distance between two signals. Of course, trains become that long later in the game, and if they are shorter, the signal distance should be shorter, then it might be possible that trains get stuck. Okay, now we have the terminal. And we go for the rest of the track up to our main line, which is in the north. So let's place these tracks step by step. And there's a reason why I don't go for long track laying, because sometimes the automatic track placement raises your track like here, and this is something I want to avoid because there are slight bumps in the terrain, but I don't want them to be on this higher ground. And if you place the track shorter, then the track will modify and will go slightly downwards or upwards, which looks much better in my opinion. So let's place it step by step in this case, and before we reach our main line over here, I want to establish another express lane over here so we can join on the main road, main track, which will be over here. This is currently a two track lane, and I want to have a four track lane because we have a lot of trains already going on this side. And if there's additional transport on the other side, it would get stuck sometimes or slow down the current frequency of lines. So I place two more lines on this side. Okay. Let's see, we have these connected to here, and I want to show you a small trick how you can handle lane crossing. I will go this line over here and over here, good distance between both, and let's join these over here and this one over here. Delete the ends over here, like so. We let this run so the train is outside of this area, and then we redo all this stuff here. Okay, let's stop it. Because right now we have a small problem on this track. Trains always need to wait on the other side if they want to cross from the northern part to the southern part. But we can do like a big cross, so it's even faster, so we delete all this. Like so. We will keep this for the normal way to go, but now we go for the left part. This over here. And there's some collision. Okay, let's delete this one. We go over here. And the second one over here should connect to here. Okay. And now we go for these stations and we establish two personal lanes for personal transport. So let's delete these buildings. And let's add another platform on this side. Or maybe we... No, let's add tracks first. Here. Let's add a platform in the middle. And another track on the other side. So we have two possible terminal stations for personal transport. And we could add another one on this side or even another track and then more personal transport. So we have four personal transport lanes. And now the station itself changed from cargo only to personal and cargo. So now we connect these two to the outer part over here and let these two tracks join into this one. Or maybe, no, we do something else. Wait a second. Yeah, we will do this another way. Because we have both express lines already set up here, we will go for these. So they can join in back later, left or right. So let's grab this line over here. And this over here. And now rejoin these into here. Also at maximum speed. Like so. And now we can go another back on this side. Over here and here. We also make a cross in this section for possible switching of tracks. Okay, too much slope. Let's see. Nope, doesn't work. Let me see. Still too much slope. Okay, we can do it this way also. This will work fine. Okay. And now we need a crossing between those two main tracks, which I will do right after this road crossing. So this is why you need to leave a gap between both lines. First of all, you go from left to right. Or in this case, right to left, at the maximum speed possible. Trains can keep their speed at high velocity. Now go for this switch on this side, to this track. And right on the opposite side, you go for the other part. Also exact same distance, as you can see over here. Now you have an almost symmetrical perfect crossing and trains can keep their speed before they reach the station. Looks like this. And now the only thing left is to join these two personal transport lanes into these, which we do by sticking them to this lane. First place some here at this side. And then let's join these here. Also at maximum speed if possible. So. And now we join these two. And the track is finished. Okay. Now, we need two more things. First of all, let's finish the left lane into our incoming train in the back end here. So we do a byte turn on this side. Because later on we have trains which go like 300 kilometers per hour. And they should keep their speed if possible. This is a slight overturn, so let's delete the last part. And now let's join these. Left side first. And where's the second one? Over here. Half a million track costs. Okay. Now these two are finished. Oh, look at this. Wasn't what I had in mind. Well, we will keep it. Some individuality doesn't matter. Okay, now we have this part. We have an express route over here. And all we need now are some signals. So let's go left and right placement as usual. And also we need two more waypoints to tell the trains where they should go and where not. We have two waypoints over here for the express lane, and now we need two waypoints for the personal line to stay on this southernmost track. We place two waypoints over here and two waypoints over here for cargo trains. Okay, let's see if this distance is 300 meter by holding station next to it. Yeah, this is fine for later tracks. And now we need some more signals on this side. So different lines can drive here on this track without stopping. And we have some visitors in our stream. Hello, everyone. Next thing we will do is setting up the transport lines. And here we are at our second station. Okay. So let's set up lines. And remember, if you have a demand, only if you meet the whole chain of supply and demand, something will show up at your station. That means also, if we don't have any personal transport, a public transport, I mean, in a city, no one will show up at your station. This also means we have to establish another public truck station at this part of the city, or bus station over here. And this should be pretty close to the train station. So we will do following. We will place it on this side, and for this we need another extension on this station, like here. So we need a passenger building platform. Let's see where we can place this one. Not here, because we are missing platforms, so we need to place these first. And this was a little bit dumb, so I redo this. I will add another track first, just in case we need to expand later on, because this city will become our central city on the map. Now we place platforms so people can actually walk onto the platforms, and now we can add buildings. Let's place a bigger one over here. And now we can add to this building on the other side of the station some bus stops. So as you can see, if I place it right here, maybe on this side, then we can also expand it later. Let's place this here, and let's grab this street over to here, so our line can go into the city from here. So this is our cargo area, and this is our public transport area. And we also could think about pushing this cargo station to this side also, so our emissions will reduce even further from this side. And all the lorry lanes would go only on the outer city street, like here. And this is, we should consider this. You know what? Let's do this. Go to buildings, truck station, and let's modify this. So we have another truck depot over here, right next to the tracks. And let's modify this. Not this one. One. Cargo platforms. And now let's edit our lines. So the truck route will go from here to these waypoints. We can get rid of these two waypoints also. And this is not Lower Wildenburg, but let's see, Upper Wildenburg. Okay, we go here, we delete this one, and then we get rid of waypoint 5 and 6. And now we have a straight line to the industrial part of the city. And all cargo will be placed onto this cargo depot, and we can also modify our tool. Let's see, which one was it? Towards the building, this one. And wait, where is the second line? This is our construction material, and we don't have... Wait, let me have a look in the overview. Don't we have tool trucks in the city? No, we don't. Oh yeah, I know, because we had influence radius from the station itself, but now it expanded, so we might consider taking another truck line for tools also here. And we can use the same spot over here. So we can get rid of this station, we will do. So city can also grow in this part. Let's confirm this. And now let's configure our truck route over here. We take the first terminal, so we can establish another line for the tools inside the city, which are in blue. So we have maybe two stops, one here and one here. Yeah, let's do this. Let's add two stops. Buildings, cargo unload stop right here and here. Let's add another line from here to here and here. So this will be our tools truck route. Okay. And as you can see, this line is also not affecting the residential area. Oh, another thing we should move is this road depot. Let's do this also. Let's put this down here, right next to all the other stuff we laid out in the south here. Delete this. And now the only thing left is configure the terminal, which is automatically set to the second one, as you can see, which is fine. So we need some more vehicles on this track. So let's buy some in this road depot. Cargo, and here we go for the motorized one. Let's buy two. And let's set these to the tool truck route. Okay. Next thing we need to set up are public transport stations. So let's go for the buildings, bus stops, and let's have some stops over in the city. Right in the middle. Here. And here, and maybe one more here. Should be fine. All this complex. And let's add this line for public transport. I will go for a yellow. So we have our main station, central. Then we go all the way up here. And maybe this time we can use these waypoints. So these public transports don't interfere with the cargo transports. So let's go for this waypoint. And do one circle around. Let's go for the second waypoint over here. And then back to the central. Okay. So we call this public transport Wildenburg. And then, of course, we need another train line from the station to mall down here. And if you click on these icons, do not misclick on the cargo icon, because it differs if you click on personal transport or cargo items. This will be yellow also, and this is called public train one, because later on we have more than one. And now we have the connection between two cities, but we also need public transport inside of mall. So let's have a look at the residential areas, which are in green. So we need at least two stops. So let's build them over one over here, which has an influence radius up north, and one over here, which should be fine. Now let's create another line, public from here to here and back to this station. Let's make this also yellow, and let's call it public transport mall. Now we have everything set up for this public transport, and now let's see what happens. First of all, I want to let it run for a little while. We also need to add some vehicles, of course, for passengers. So let's grab best possible, which is these Landerers. So let's go for four on the for Wildenburg, let's buy two for Mall. And let's buy some trains for the big connection. In this case, do we have electric already? No, let's go for a steam. It's the fastest, 100. Oh, by the way, if you buy engines, always make sure that you have the correct engines for the maximum possible speed. If you have a look at the passenger wagons, this one has maximum speed of 100 and this one 60. So it doesn't make sense if you buy these ones and an engine with 100 max speed. So in this case, the only thing we can afford is like 100. So let's buy these wagons. And I'm not looking at the capacity, but I'm looking at the maximum length, which is currently 240 meters for my actual station. So I go for the maximum here, 240, which equals to, yeah, approximately, what is it? About 250 capacity, which is way over the top. So I reduce it to have the higher velocity at the beginning, and we should aim for like 200 in the begin maximum. So let's choose a steam engine for 100 max, which is only the last one. Okay, let's buy this one for 15 million. It's not cheap. So personal transport isn't an option in the beginning, from my point of view. Let's add this to public train 1 and let's see what happens. Okay, let this run. And let's have a look at all the other lines on this new build track, if everything works fine out. We have this station automatically chosen by the AI here. We have our good lines on the northern part, and we have our... Oh, there are missing some... Yeah, we're missing a crossing over here. So the train can go back on this track. Let me see. Right now the yellow line, the public line, is only on the left. But we need left-right traffic. This means there is one place that can join the right track again. Let's see. This should be over here. Oh, it has the possibility on this way. So we have to place some more signals. Let's do this on this side and on this side. Now the line should be... Nope. Still not. This is weird. It's coming in here. Okay, let's stop it here, and I want this train to go on the right track. Why isn't it working? Let's make this sticky so we can see yellow track if I close the line window. Okay. Maybe we should set up the second waypoint. Yeah, let's do this. So from Wildenburg, we add another station, which will be the right. Okay, now it says there is no way that it reaches the... Okay, the problem is up at this station. We have no way going left on this track, right? Oh, is this track maybe bugged or something? Let's see. We go straight. Oh, it should work fine. Let's see. This is weird. Somewhere on this track there's a something which doesn't allow the train to go straight. Yeah, I think it's this part of the track. Let's see if we can rebuild this one. Oh, let's go straight here. Not really. Maybe I've placed the signal on the wrong spot. Can happen from time to time. Not zooming out correctly. Yeah, and this is looking weird from the auto placement. Wonder if this is the problem. Yeah, let's do this in another way. Because I don't like this. Oh, and maybe we can switch the terminals also. Yeah, let's see. This is terminal 3. Should be fine. Train. Oh, did I miss part of the track right here? Somewhere? Oh, here it is. Okay, that's a problem. Here we go. I missed a small bit of the track. Okay. Let it run and I will place these tracks again. Okay, here it comes. And let's have a look at the station. No public passengers right now. Why? Because we have no buses yet. So let's add some buses to this and then they will come to the station. So we need... Oh, we have, but we didn't assign the right line. So public transport mall, is it? Okay. Now these small icons should have some passengers, and you can also see this on the public transport layer, street traffic. Right now there is one here, and if you look at this overlay, you will see there's public transport demand from here, which is in blue, to these two facilities, but on the destination layer there's nothing going to Wildenberg. So we can go for a mall in the overlay. Yeah, there is now public transport with 4 people, as you can see here, but 3 or 4 on this side of the town. So we should consider placing one more station over here in the commercial district. So let's do this by placing another stop over here. Let's edit this line here, and yeah, let's add the station first, going like a cross shape. Okay. Also in Wildenberg, we can have a look at the public transport. Right now there is none, because we didn't assign the trucks or buses. So let's see in the vehicle manager. Wildenberg Road Depot, we have 4 vehicles, and now we assign them to this. Here they come. And now there are passengers popping up on all the stations. And let's have a look. Public transport should increase in a minute. Yeah, we have 10 passengers right now on this lane, which is the yellow one between Wildenberg and Marl. See the numbers here. And as you can see, there is the demand is even rising in this small city, so over time we will have a lot of passengers on this train. Right now it's in the negatives because costs are higher than profit, but this is fine for now. As I told before, don't expect personal transport to be lucrative in the beginning, but it will rise over time. Okay, so we established our first personal transport, yellow line over here. And we also established our public transport in Lindenburg here. And in Marl. Here. Okay, next thing we should consider is establishing another construction material route between this depot, because it has now productivity of level 1, below 100, but we have a lot of rocks stored. And we have more available at the quarry, which is over here. You can see 227, so we could produce even more. So we should establish another line. Oh, something's wrong over here. Let's see. These two interfere. Okay, this is a problem. And yeah, we should place another signal up before this part of the track. So let's place this here, and let's turn this train around, so this can pass. And we need to place signals over here as well, before this switch. So let's do this. Like so. And yeah, two more here. Okay. This should be fine now. Okay, let's create another line for construction material from this depot. And we go for Terminal 2, which is, let me see, this one, yeah, right, also red color, to Marl, over here, on track 3, no, it's 1, but I would say we go to 2, because this should be the express lane through the station, and then we can establish another truck line inside of Marl for the construction material, which is located in the outer parts right here, I think. Yeah, the yellow part. So we add another unload station over here. Let's put it on this side, and we create another line from this depot to the station, also in red, so I have a whole line all the time. And we call this one construction material track Marl, and this we will rename to Wildenberg. And this line is CM to Marl, train line. And now the last thing we need is one more train. And you can do yourself a favor by going to the vehicle manager choose your first VM train, click on it, duplicate it, and then you assign it to the new root. So you don't have to click the whole process of adding cargo wagons and trains, etc. Okay, now we go into this building, add cargo lorries, I would say 2, and add these to the wall line. Now we have a whole circle of material and supply and demand again. And we can have a look at the line manager to see if it's profitable or not. So let's follow the new one. This train. And also let's have a look if this lane is going the right track. Yeah, it's the same as the personal transport, as you can see. That's the right one. Now it should go on the leftmost part of the track at this intersection here. Yes. And it also staying in the middle part of the station on the express lane. As it should be. Also, as in the background you can see personal transport decreased and public transport has risen already. And another thing, if you have such a long line from two cities, you should consider of putting your material waiting time into at least half of the truck, of the train. Or at 75%, so it's 3/4 full before it leaves the station. Because this is now producing more and should upgrade in a little while. And this train won't go empty. This is important. Okay, right now there's nothing at this station. Why? See. It's not producing anything. Let me have a look at the destination. Are there any... Does the cargo need... Oh, is it connected? Yeah, it is. Okay. That's weird. Let's see. Oh, no, there is. Okay. There's one on the train right now. It takes some time until the whole system notices the demand. So there is one on the train right now. Yeah, you can see here. Maybe we need more. Oh yeah, there's no stone stored. This is why it's not producing. So let's have a look at the quarry line. Where is it? Here. Where are our trains? This one is full. And the second one is empty, which is going back right now. Oh, and why is it going on the left track? This is the wrong one. Wait a second. This is weird. This should stay on the right track, not on the left one. Let me see. Oh, I see. There is no connection, so it can stick to the left side. So we have to place another switch over here. So it can go from the left, from the right track to the left one. And this is... Oh, there is, actually. Huh. Let me see. Where does it switch? Okay, it switches over here. but it shouldn't. Maybe we should add... Oh, there are signals already. Yeah, let's set this terminal to 2. And let's add another crossing in front of it, so it can switch back to the other side. Like so. Oh, it's working. Okay. And also 56 capacity on this line is way too low. So let's try and upgrade these trains on this line. Vehicle manager, query both of them, and let's replace them with better engines. Okay, do we have better? No, we can take these with 100. And then we need cargo or stone. So let's add way more capacity. We can add up to 240 meters. So let's add 28. 238. This is fine. Okay. So let's buy 2. And this should increase our construction material factory output significantly. And now let's have a look. It's also way faster now. Yeah, let's keep this one on open window and the second one too. Let's have a look at our public train. It's still in the negatives, but already halved its costs, which was like 1.2 million before. Yeah. If you have a station where you have a lot of output on your facility, but you don't have a lot of storage room, then you can add more cargo platforms to it, so it can store more stuff on it. In this case, we can add some more here. And cargo buildings should also increase the amount of cargo stored inside. Let's see if we can some here. It's also visually a little upgrade. That was the wrong one. Like so. Okay, let's see. This is on the way back. This is on the way to the factory. And this should be about 2.6 million in profit. Just from this one delivery, there's our personal transport. And I should check this signal placement on this switch, because there was a waiting time. It was not as I expected. Okay, let's follow this train, and then we have a look at the emissions again in our main city. There's a takeover here, also nice. And we have so much money, we should consider to upgrade all our engines to the better ones. But we are also in the early 19s, so there should be way better engines, and the first electrical and diesel engines also in a couple of years. So maybe we wait until better engines pop up. So let's see how much we get out of this cargo delivery. 5.3 million. Okay, way more than I expected. Just insane profitable. Let's see, balance. Yeah, the query is top-notch now. At an interval of 6 minutes, with this cargo capacity to 22 wagons. This is awesome. Also, let's have a quick look at our wood production, because I think this is producing only half capacity, but it has a lot of planks left over. Yeah. Okay, let's have a look at our emissions. They dropped in here, so our Wildenberg should, now it's still on poor, minus 30%. But as you can see, it's not that bad as before. It was really dark and red in this side. This is only from the public transport right now. And there's a lot of demand on this station. Look at this, 42 people waiting to go for on the public transport. So we should increase our vehicle count on this lane. Okay, let's see. Frequency is 107 seconds, 41 is the rate. Yeah, let's buy more transport on this lane. Go to vehicle. And let's add two more by copying and cloning the vehicles. And also I want to paint them yellow so we have visibility. These are the public transports. Also for the train, like here. So let's paint this yellow. Okay, here we are at the station. A lot of people waiting already. And we did profit of 700k, which is nice. There's the other transport. Let's see. Yeah, it's also on the profit right now. That's nice. So, our two new routes established, and as you can see, there's a lot of goods already available at this station. And Maul is delivering right now. Let's see, where are the cargo trucks over here? 5. Yeah, this is the first delivery. So let's have a look at this lorry. Okay. So if I let this run for some years, this should be in the positives. And our public transport to Mall, this one, should also get profitable if the amount of passenger rises. Okay. This is everything you have to consider in your personal transport if you want to establish it, and also keep in mind the placement of your stations and your lines in terms of emissions. Try not to overdo it or your city growth will will be impacted significantly, and this should be a factor you take in mind if you place something. Remember, industrial buildings or commercial districts are not affected at all. It only counts for residential areas. Okay, that's it for this episode, and if you want, you can join in back next time. If we reach the middle of 19th century, we will also establish some airports and personal transport. Right now, we have a good economy, a lot of income, and I will also establish more personal transport lines off screen, and then we come back in later in a more stable game and with a lot more lines. So, if you want, join back in next time, and thank you for watching, and see you around.